Assassin's Creed movie coming out, there's one question that some people will probably think about. Does Assassin's Creed Embers count as an Assassin's Creed movie? Because even though it doesn't have a DVD release, it was still released, produced, it's still a kind of film-based thing. Although it was originally released along with Assassin's Creed Revelations as a way of saying goodbye to Ezio. But this, I think, would still count as an Assassin's Creed movie, even though it's only 22 minutes.
And it's animated in whether it looks like a short film from the fucking Animatrix. But it's also not bad. anyone new to Assassin's Creed will be completely fucking lost by the character introduction. But it also wasn't meant to introduce people to the series. It was meant as a for fans of the series of Assassin's Creed 2 Brotherhood, well, of the Ezio ones, to say goodbye to a character that they've spent so much fucking time playing. No one has the only character you'd spent longer with was Desmond, and it fucking tossed him in the next game, a game that until Unity came out was the one that no one talked about. It was the black sheep of the Assassin's Creed franchise. The bigger insult to it wasn't that Assassin's Creed 3 existed, it followed the Ezio games, and it followed this. An interesting story that gave a satisfying ending to one of the best characters. Say what you want about Ubisoft, but they did Ezio right. Sure, he couldn't climb up fucking trees like the assassin I'm not going to talk about, or climb down buildings like Evie Fry, but he was still fucking hilarious and a master assassin. You felt like a fucking assassin, unlike Altair, who died anytime he touched fucking water. But anyway, yeah, let's just start the fucking review.
I am taking Marcello into town.
To see Machiavelli's play.
Ezio, his play closed 3 weeks ago.
I missed it.
We are visiting your sister. Keep an eye on Flavia, okay?
Si, of course.
He fucking immediately, you can tell there's something wrong with Ezio. You can tell that he knows he doesn't have much time left to spend with his family. And by the fact that he's currently writing a letter that you will hear at the end of it being read out by Ezio. Then there's the fucking music. If I hear one person insulting the music to this, I will hunt you the fuck down and slowly torture you with bloody knives, feathers, chains, I think I have a whip somewhere, a brick, screwdriver. You could see what I can do with a fucking pen. In fact, I might just use a pen. So, while Ezio walks through the field, he sees Flavia walking with another assassin, and he immediately goes apeshit.
Leave her alone!
Gentile, papà.
Go inside, Flavia. I do not know what else to say. I'm sorry. I do not want any part of this.
I want to understand.
Understand what?
How to lead, to rebuild my order.
No, for me that is over. Benito, now I think you should go.
Ezio, she has come a long way. Xiao Yun, did I say that right? Would you stay for supper? Grazie. Good, we have a spare bedroom. You're welcome to stay a few nights.
So, Ezio is a little hostile towards the idea of training Xiao Yun, and then see him talking, saying that he thinks he doesn't have enough time, and that he thinks that he started a family too late, that he'd probably die before they get older. In the next morning, he finds Xiao Yun in his study and again goes fucking apeshit. That's twice now. I probably should have started a fucking counter. In fact,
get out!
The wind! It opens the door!
Fuori!
I was wrong.
See, I think you need to go.
My name is Ezio Auditore. When I was a young man, I had liberty, but I did not see it. I had time, but I did not know it. And I had love, but I did not feel it. It would be 30 long years before I understood the meaning of all three. I want to understand, like you do, to help my people.
I was an assassin for a long time, Yun. And I know that at any moment, someone could come for me, or my family. Do you see? This is why I must be careful. I usually hire people to help me with vendange, the grape harvest, but Indra, let us get something to eat.
So they go to Florence, and Ezio tells Xiao Yun that assassins are meant to give people hope and to stop them from living in fear, and then they're immediately attacked by other people sent by the Emperor of China or whatever the fuck And Xiaoyan shows up, and she has a fucking hidden blade in her fucking shoe. So, on the way back to Ezio's manor, or whatever the fuck it is, we find out that Xiaoyun was born a concubine, but was freed because just having the Emperor being against the assassins wouldn't make him enough of a fucking villain or anything. But no. Then Ezio talks about Rome and Constantinople and says that if you don't fight for hope, you aren't a fucking assassin. That is what they want, to give people fucking hope. And then the villa, whatever the fuck, is attacked. This is where it could have ended, with it could have just killed Ezio at the tree and had Xiaoyun travel back to China to rebuild the assassins in the name of Ezio Auditore. But no, it actually has him give her a box saying to only open it if she really fucking needed to. You'll know what the fuck's in the box. Just called the Pulp Fiction box or whatever the fuck. And then he goes to Florence, where he meets this asshole.
Al diavolo. I hate this damn city. I wish I was in Rome. I hear the women there are, like ripe Sangiovese on the vine, you know? Not like here, Firenze.
I don't think Firenze is your problem.
Prego? Coraggio, vecchio. Get some rest, huh?
I was a young man.
And just like what's in the box could be left to your own interpretation, the identity of that guy could also be up to your interpretation. It could be he's a Templar assassin, some random guy, or death. Maybe just in his head, because he kind of disappears the minute they turn around. It could actually have just been him talking to himself. Also, this is really fucking depressing. But this is how Ezio died. Not stabbed in a battle or anything, just dying peacefully and soundly on a bench in Firenze. And then we get this speech.
I had liberty, but I did not see it. I had time, but I did not know it. And I had love, but I did not feel it. Many decades would pass before I understood the meaning of all three. And now, in the twilight of my life, this understanding has passed into contentment. Love, liberty, and time, once so disposable, are the fuels that drive me forward. And love, most especially, mio caro, for you, our children, our brothers and sisters, and for the vast and wonderful world that gave us life and keeps us guessing. Endless affection, mia Sofia. Forever yours, Ezio Auditore.
And that's it. Just a short 21-22 minute thing to say goodbye to Ezio Auditore, the best fucking assassin, and I'm saying the best because yes, Edward Kemmer had fucking ship. But Ezio still came first. Without Ezio, there wouldn't be an Edward Kenway. He thinks he's responsible for Edward. He's also a fucking kick-ass assassin. Also, theorize whatever the fuck you want about what was in the box, or whether he was killed, or how he died. Everyone fucking else is. Jesus. Put his poison theory, Templar theory, natural causes theory. There's probably something has to do with the Chinese assassins theory. But, yeah. It's just too for fans of Ezio to say goodbye. If you can find a copy of it, fucking watch it. I find this one on YouTube. And yeah, the interesting thing is this came with Assassin's Creed Revelations. It doesn't have a DVD release unless I missed one somewhere. If you can find a DVD of it, fucking buy it. Cause this, it counts as a fucking film, but this is worth fucking paying for. And as far as does this count as an Assassin's Creed movie? Fucking yes! Fuck's sake. Yeah, so the new Assassin's Creed film, it is the first live action Assassin's Creed film, but this is the first Assassin's Creed film, and even though it does have matrixy fucking fight scenes. So yeah, if you liked the video, like, comment, and subscribe. And remember, I will be seeing you very soon. Bye.
Well, I bit the bullet, I drunk it dry. My heart is spilling over the sides of a tall glass of whiskey that's killing the pain. My wings were broken, all feathers in flame. Heart pumping black and blue, swirling down the pit. I ain't been me since Zephyr came and went. They told me I would fly. They told me I would fly.